Doki Doki Literature Club. This is really cute.
Yeah? Mimi.
We're back to where we started. Alright, let's go. Sayori is vice president of the Literature Club. Not that I was ever aware that she had any interest in literature. In fact, I'm 99% sure she only did it because she felt it would be fun to help start a new club. Since she was the first one to show interest after the one who proposed the club, she inherited the title of vice president. That said, my interest in literature is guaranteed to be even less. Yeah, I'm going to the anime club.
Come on, please.
Why do you care so much anyway?
Well, I kind of told the club yesterday I'd bring in a new member. And Natsuki made cupcakes and everything.
Don't make promises you can't keep. I can't tell Sayori is really that much of an airhead, or if she's so cunning as to have planned all this out and had it alongside. Fine. I'll stop by for a cupcake, okay?
Yes, let's go.
And thus, today marks the day I sold my soul for a cupcake. I dejectedly followed Sayori across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used for third year classes and activities. Sayori, full of energy, swings open the classroom door.
Everyone, the new member is here.
I told you, don't call me a new member. Eh? I glance across the room.
Welcome to the literature club. It's a pleasure to meet you. Sayori always says nice things about you.
Seriously, you brought a boy?
Way to kill the atmosphere.
Ah, Patrick, what a nice surprise.
It's a lolly and a tsundere. Yeah.
Bad touch, stranger danger.
Welcome to the club.
What was escaping this situation?
This club.
It's full of incredibly cute girls. Okay. First off, the only one I find cute is the name of the childhood friend, okay? Tsundere, they're freaky.
What are you looking at?
Six is a tsundere.
If you want to say something, say it.
Sorry.
Natsuki.
The girl with the sour attitude, whose name is apparently Natsuki, is one I don't recognize. Her small figure makes me think she's probably a first year. She's also one who made cupcakes, according to Sayori.
You can ignore her when she gets moody.
Sayori says that quietly into my ear, then turns back towards the other girls.
Anyway, this is Natsuki, always full of energy.
Energy?
And this is Yuri, the smartest in the club. Don't say things like that.
Yuri, who appears comparably more mature and timid, seems to have a hard time keeping up with people like Sayori and Natsuki. Well, it's nice to meet both of you.
It sounds like you already know Monica. Is that right?
That's right.
It's great to see you again, Patrick.
We do know each other. Well, we really talk. But we were in the same class last year. Monica was probably the most popular girl in class. Smart, beautiful, athletic.
Second one, not right.
Probably the first one as well. Basically, completely out of my league. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little...
Sit down, Patrick. We made a room for you at the table, so you can sit next to me or Monica. I'll get the cupcakes. Hey, I made them. I'll get them.
Sorry, I got a little too excited.
And How about I make some tea as well?
I'm fine with that. I'm fine with tea. I prefer coffee, though. Don't let them hear that. The girls have a few desks arranged to form a table. As I already mentioned, in wine so that there's one space next to Monica and one space next to Sayori. And Suki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. Then Suki proudly marches back to the table and lays a hand.
Okay, are you ready? Ta-da!
Natsuki lifts the rolls off the tray to reveal a dozen white, fluffy cupcakes decorated to look more like cats. The white scoops are drawn with icing, and little pieces of chocolate were used to make ears.
So cute! I had no idea you were so good at baking, Natsuki.
Well, you know.
Aw, she's even got the little tooth, too. Alright.
Just hurry and take one.
Sayori grabs one first and Monica, I follow.
It's delicious.
Sayori talks with a mouthful and has already managed to get icing on her face. I turn the cupcakes around my fingers, looking at the best angle to take a bite. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. Is she waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down. The icing is sweet and full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. This is really good. Thank you, Sayori Natsuki.
But why are you thanking me? It's not like I...
B-b-b-baka!
I thought I heard this word before.
Make them for you, Raven.
Sayori said,
well, maybe, but not for you, no, you, dummy.
Alright. I give up on Natsuki's weird logic and dismiss the conversation. Yeah, I dismiss it immediately, too. Yuri returns to the table, carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us, before sitting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray. You gave a whole tea set in the classroom?
Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, isn't a hot cup of tea to help you enjoy it?
I guess.
Don't let yourself get into the game. Yuri's just trying to impress you. That's not...
Insulted, Yuri looks away.
I meant that, you know.
I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but I at least enjoy tea.
I'm glad.
Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief. Monica raises a brow and smiles at me.
So, what may you consider the literature club?
That. Mouthful. I was afraid of this question. Something tells me I shouldn't tell Monica that I was practically dragged here by Sayori. I haven't joined any clubs yet, but Sayori seemed really, really happy here, so...
That's okay, don't be embarrassed. We'll make sure you feel right at home, okay? As the president of the Literature Club, it's my duty to make the club fun and exciting for everyone.
Monica, I'm surprised. How come you decided to start your own club? You could probably be a board member for any of the major clubs. Weren't you a leader of the debate club last year?
Well, you know.
Seems like a classical white girl to me.
To be honest, I can't stand all of the politics around the major clubs. It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicity and how to prepare for events. I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy and make something special out of it. And if it encourages others to get into literature, then I'm fulfilling that dream. Monica really is a great leader.
Yuri also nods in agreement. I'm surprised more people in the club yet. It must be hard to start a new club.
You could put it that way. Not many people are very interested in putting out all the effort to start something brand new. Especially when it's something that doesn't grab your attention like literature. You have to work hard to convince people that you're both fun and worthwhile. But it makes school events, like the festival, that much more important. I'm confident that we can all really grow this club before we graduate. Right, everyone? Yeah. We'll do our best. You know it.
Everyone enthusiastically agrees.
Why does she look like Naruto?
Believe it!
Such different girls, all interested in the same goal. Monica must have worked really hard just to find these three. Maybe that's why they were all so delighted by the idea of a new paper tree. Well, I still don't know if I can keep up with their level of enthusiasm about literature.
So, Patrick, what kind of things do you like to read?
Considering how little I've read these past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering that.
Manga?
I muttered quietly to myself, half joking.
Natsuki's head suddenly pricks up.
It looks like she wants to say something, but she keeps quiet.
Not much of a reader, I guess.
Well, that can change. I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri?
Let's see.
Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her fingers.
My favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. They're full of creativity and craftsmanship. Behind them is amazing to me. And telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive.
Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. She seems so reserved and timid. Since the moment I walked in, it is obvious that by the way her eyes light up, that she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people.
But you know, I like a lot of things.
It starts with deep psychological elements, usually immersive in the sort as well. Isn't it amazing how our writer can so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you in for a moment? Anyway, I've been reading a lot of horror lately.
I've read a horror book once. I'm reading one right now, apparently.
I desperately grasp something I can relate to at a minimal level. At this rate, Yuri might as well be having a conversation with a rock.
Really? I wouldn't have expected that, Yuri.
For someone as gentle as you, I guess you could say that. But if a story makes me think, or takes me to another world, then I really can't put it down. Surreal horror is often very successful in changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment.
I hate horror.
Oh, what's that?
Well, I just...
Atsuki's eyes dart over to me for a split second.
Never mind.
That's right, you usually like to write about cute things, don't you, Natsuki?
But what?
What gives you that idea?
You left a piece of scrap paper behind last club meeting. It looked like you were working on a poem called
Don't Say It Out Loud and Give That Back.
Fine.
Your cupcakes, your poems, everything you do is just as cute as you are.
Settles up behind Natsuki and puts her hands on her shoulders.
I'm not cute!
Natsuki, you write your own poems?
Eh? Well, I guess sometimes.
Why, you care? I think it's impressive. Why don't you share them sometime?
No.
Natsuki averts her eyes.
You would like them.
Not a very confident writer yet.
I understand how Natsuki feels. Showing that level of writing takes more than just confidence. The truest form of writing is writing to oneself. You must be willing to open up experience too, Yuri. Maybe if you share some of your work, you can set an example of her and help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers.
I guess it's the same for Yuri.
I want to read everyone's poems.
We all sit in silence for a moment.
You know, I think we're gonna save there. We're gonna save there. We've progressed enough.
Anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let's do another one. I'll see you guys next time.
Hello, everyone!